You good?
Yeah.
So how did you start down the road on this particular project?
Non ho capito. Come hai iniziato con per questo progetto?
Ah, ho cominciato. I started to gather stuff about Rome, about the people that I saw in Rome, the context. And then after I found a main character that could be a sort of traveler inside Rome, inside this world, and for this reason the main character is above all a journalist, a writer and a journalist. Yeah.
So are you, did you think of it as a Fellini-esque piece? Is it a modern piece of revisiting some of the ideas that...
I prefer to leave Fellini in his... Imperial, okay.
Empire.
Empire, yeah. I am very down. And so, no. But some context, some environment are the same of the Fellini's movie. For this reason, it could be, I can understand that some people does a comparison with the Fellini's movie, yeah.
Well, you, I think in Il Divo also, you're kind of a historian. You're a feature filmmaker. You're a non-fiction filmmaker, or fiction filmmaker. But there's that. You seem to be very interested in non-fiction, in the history of the place.
Dice che tu quando fai film, anche nel Divo, è molto non finzione, che anche c'è la parte storica che tu in.
For me, it's pretty important to put the hands in the reality and then to reinvent it. But I start from the reality and a real moment in the life of a context or of a country or of an environment that I would love to tell.
So is that what you consume normally outside of just making a particular movie? Are you a person who reads a lot of nonfiction and is into the... Are you a historian in a way?
Oh, yes, yes, without being obsessed, but yes, I normally do.
So what is it that about Rome right now that you felt needed a conversation?
Non ho capito.
Allora dice perché, allora cosa c'ha a Roma che hai dovuto fare questo film? Che cosa ha Roma?
Many things. There is a great contrast between the beauty of Rome and another kind of beauty more hidden about the people that live in Rome, and they appear like vulgar and full of squalor, but behind this kind of stuff we can find four fragments also beauty in the some people that live in Rome. And and Rome of course is the most important city of Italy, so the stuff that happened there is also a metaphor of everything can happen in Italy. So for this reason, in this historical moment, I thought that it was interesting to do a movie about Rome and the people of Rome, and about this sort of decadence that we can smell in Italy, probably also because we are living after 20 years of a political atmosphere that's not the best for the life of the people.
So you're interested in the disconnect between reality and the image, the surface?
Disconnect between reality and image, disconnessione tra...
La sconnessione.
No, I work about... No, I think... I don't know if I disconnect. I think that I start from the reality and then I try to do the stuff that do all the directors to reinvent the reality in a stylized form that I prefer as a spectator and as a filmmaker.
So your films are the kind of films you like?
Oh yes, yes. it's the kind of movie that I would love to see as a filmmaker, as a spectator.
And do you see many of them anymore? Is this kind of a dead form in some ways?
Oh yeah, yeah. It happens that I see many movies about. Yeah, for this reason I love many American directors of today, uh-huh. because like Coen Brothers, like two Anderson, Wes Anderson and Paul Thomas Anderson. They are very connected with the reality, but then they have this unbelievable ability to do something very precise that apparently could be fake, but it's real.
So does the Italian cinema culture embrace this at this point?
Se la cultura,
se la cultura del cinema italiano lo abbraccia questo pensiero?
No, probably not. The Italian cinema is very different. Everybody has his style, but usually the Italian filmmakers don't have a great attention to the visual style of a movie. They prefer to concentrate the attention about other things, probably.
A modern phenomenon, or has that been that way for a while? I know in the U.S. we complain all the time about, comic book movies and 3D and everything is kind of big and stupid these days and from the studios. Is there kind of is that also happening in Europe? Is that also part of what's happening in the Italian cinema?
Tu hai visto come fanno adesso tutti quei film che fanno adesso in tre dimensioni in America che sono molto stupidi? Dice sta succedendo in Italia la stessa cosa?
No. Also because we don't have the money to do stupid movie in 3D. We do stupid movie and stop without 3D.
2D dumb it.
Yeah, okay. Too less expensive. But in Italy there is a tendency to do many, many comedies for box office reasons. This is not a beautiful thing that the producers are going to do so many comedies that other kind of movies are a little bit forgotten.
Mm-hmm.
And probably this is one of the artistic problems that we have in Italy. Yeah.
Is it hard for you to get films made? I mean, El Divo was kind of a big hit. Yes?
No, I am lucky because Il Divo was a big success and also this Must Be the Place and also this, luckily, mm-hmm. so I have an audience that following me and so it makes easier for me to do the movies in Italy.
This Must Be the Place kind of had a hard time getting birthed in the U.S. Is that a frustration? Is that does it change the dynamic or you've had the success in other places and that's... Fine.
Dice che ha avuto difficoltà a nascere il tuo film negli Stati Uniti per questo qua.
This Must Be the Place.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes. This Must Be the Place was a failure in the United.
Well, it was barely released. It took forever, and then it kind of sat, and then it barely got a real release even.
Okay. Dice che ci ha avuto difficoltà a essere distribuito, che prima l'hanno deciso, poi l'hanno fatto aspettare, poi ripartito. Ti ha frustrato sta cosa?
I was a little bit disappointed because the movie was in the hands of Harvey Weinstein and we had, not me, but other people had the trust of him and of his strategies.
Mm-hmm.
I was a little bit skeptical and...
you were right.
I were right. Anyway, but I don't like to give the culp, the fault to the other people. So probably it's also my fault that the movie was not good for the United States. Luckily, in Italy, it was a good success, and this is important for me because I work mostly in Italy.
And you're working on budget levels that make that a viable. If it works in Europe, that's enough. I mean, it's great if it works in the United States also financially, but that's not necessary for your career to keep going.
Dice che il budget con cui tu lavori, basta che ha successo in Italia, non è... Certo, se fa successo negli Stati Uniti va bene, però dice ti basta.
Yeah, it's enough for the Italy, the budget that I have. But the movie, for example, this movie is sold in many, many countries around the world, so this is a good thing for everybody.
So do you... How long was this movie in the process of getting made?
Quanto ci è voluto per farlo
su questo film?
Sì.
1 year and a half. Yeah, 1 year. 1 year.
From the time you started conceiving.
Right. Yeah, yeah. I wrote very, very quickly the movie, and then I prepared quickly, and but I shoot for several, for many, many weeks, more than 12 weeks. And then, yeah, more than 1 year, all the process of the creation of the movie.
So is that fast for you, or is that?
It's always the same time. I need 1 or 2. I need usually two years to do a movie. Yeah.
So are you already focused on your next thing, or are you kind of waiting for
the show? I am starting to think about. Yeah, but I don't have a project for the next feature. But I am
for
starting.
TIFF next year. You don't have one to bring back.
No, for the next.
So when you found the character who would take us on this journey, this actor was an obvious choice.
This actor was
una scelta ovvia.
Per me questo attore, it's the fourth movie that we do together, and for this movie in particular way, he was perfect for many, many reasons. There is a good similarity between the character and him, and so he was the perfect actor for that role.
And do you start tailoring the screenplay to him as you go?
Si comincia a scrivere per lui.
No, che lo fai proprio per lui, l'hai fatto per lui.
I start to write. When I start to write, it's because I have in my mind an actor for that role.
That's the case in other movies as well?
Oppure negli altri film
l'hai
fatto.
Always. Huh. I think to the I need to have an actor that can do the role. Yeah. Otherwise I don't write.
So how many characters in this movie did you kind of have an idea of who you wanted to be in them?
Just
the one?
Just for, it works for the main character. For the other role, I can work without having actors.
And as you're writing this, it seems like there are all kinds of directions you could have gone in terms of segments of the film, pieces of the puzzle where you wanted him to go and things you wanted to talk about. Did you see it as an expansive world, or was there a very narrow idea of where you wanted to go with this story?
con la storia del film tu potevi andare da qualsiasi parte, cioè potevi andare in qualsiasi direzione, ma era troppo costoso andare in qualsiasi direzione, oppure avevi un'idea precisa?
No, avevo un'idea precisa dello script e volevo che la storia andasse esattamente in quella
It's okay.
Sì, volevo che andasse esattamente in quella direzione, sì.
I had the story that wanted to go in that direction exactly.
And was the production, which step is harder for you at this point? Or is there a difference in terms of coming up with a creation, writing it, and then ultimately putting it on its feet and shooting it? Is there one step that's much more significant than the other, or are they equally?
For me?
Yeah.
The step of the...
Per la produzione, per la scrittura, per la...
Cosa ti piace di più?
No, qual è più stato più difficile o cosa tutti uguali?
It depends on the movies. Usually the shooting is hard. For this movie, the shooting was hard. It was all night, in summer, very hot, many people, many extras, and so it was hard, the shooting. Usually the easy moment is the writing of the movie. The easy and the more exciting is, without doubt, the writing of the movie.
Do you have pleasure there when you're sweating and it's 2 o'clock in the morning and you're shooting, or is that just work?
I don't love. I go. No. It's also a good sensation to work in the night, but it's definitely tiring. Yeah.
And is post production a big? Do you find things in post production in a significant way? I mean, obviously they're small things, but does your movie change in post? Or
yeah. Usually In post-production, I try to change many things, but usually I am not able to change nothing. So I go back to the first. The first editing of the movie that respects the script.
Do you have people who tell you that you should change this or do that, or are there a lot of voices in your ear?
My editor and the assistant of the editors, I hear a lot of them, and also my storyboard producer. All my movies, I like
I like that he participates to see the movie and to see things that we can change. Yeah.
So you took the movie at premiere to Cannes?
Excuse me?
I've fatto la prima a Cannes.
Oh, yes, yes.
Stressful at that point, or did you feel like you had done your work? And
no, Cannes is very stressful. Cannes is very... It's the first appointment with the audience, with the press, with the people of the cinema. And Cannes is very stressful for me, yeah.
You sat and watched the movie, I assume?
I saw the movie
with the audience,
yeah.
Is that nerve-wracking, or are you waiting for a moment where you know they're going to laugh, or that you're expecting them to laugh, and you feel better after they?
Sei nervoso quando lo guardi e aspetti quando che ridano al momento
yes,
che voglio
yes,
che ridano.
I am very nervous. Yeah. I hope that they laugh.
And do you feel good once they do? Do you feel relief, or is it stressful the whole way through?
Ma quando ridono stai bene oppure sei nervoso fino alla fine?
I am nervous till the end.
So you're nervous when you come here too, or are you?
No. Also here, because Toronto is an important festival. There's a different audience from Europe, so it's stressful for me also this festival. Yeah.
And did you watch it with an audience here again, or?
Yeah, yesterday I saw with the audience.
So very different reactions, or pretty similar?
No, I have to say that there are similar reactions. The movie. Yeah.
Are there surprises for you? What people react to? Or are you?
I am not surprised because I don't ask myself what can happen with the movie. I don't know. I am open to wait a reaction. So
you don't have the expectations going into?
I prefer to not have expectation. Otherwise, if the expectation are not satisfied, I am disappointed. So I prefer to go without expectation.
It seems kind of challenging, no?
Yeah.
Does it get easier as you made more films?
No, capito questo.
Ma diventa più facile più fai film?
Se diventa più facile fare film?
No, se diventa più facile questo challenge che c'hai avuto.
You get used to it, I guess.
Oppure ti diventa facile, più fai film più ti diventa facile il tutto.
Oh yeah. Movie after movie, I am more used to the circus, and so I am a little bit more relaxed. Yeah.
So you're used to the circus, is that what you said?
Diventi ti abitui al circo?
Yes, a little bit, and yeah, a little bit.
And do you like talking about your work, or is it
not too much? I prefer talking about football.
About football?
About soccer.
So who's your team?
Naples,
okay. How are they doing?
We are going very well. We are at the beginning of the championship. We are at the first position.
And I guess the coach, when he shows up, gets nervous also.
L'allenatore quando si presenta pure sarà nervoso.
Oh yes, in Italy, about football, everybody is nervous.
So
not
you have
only the not only the trainer, everybody.
So you have it easy.
Quindi per te è facile.
Yeah.